I remember when I was a beginner guitarist, I used to be fascinated watching my favorite guitar players strumming effortlessly. And then I would observe a stark difference in the way beginners or amateur guitarists do it. It just didn't sound or feel right. So I used to wonder, is there a correct way? Is there a proper step-by-step method that we can follow in order to ensure that our strumming sounds like a professional player? Today I'm going to teach you four easy steps which you can start incorporating right now in order to ensure that every time you strum on the guitar, you sound like a pro. What's up everybody, welcome back. This is Dhanesh from learnguitaronline.in and today we are going to be talking about one of my personal favorite topics, which is strumming. Now before we take a deeper look at how to fix your strumming and make it sound professional, let's first understand what is strumming. In this lesson series, Guitar Made Fun and Easy for Beginners, we have earlier spoken about fretting as well as picking. And when I was referring to picking, I was mostly talking about playing individual notes on single strings, something like this. To make it short and simple, strumming is the activity of playing multiple guitar strings together, especially when you're playing chords, so that you can create harmonized guitar lines which can support mostly vocal melodies. So you would mostly use strumming in order to play songs on the guitar while you're singing or you're supporting somebody else who is doing the singing. It could also be used in cases where some other instrument is playing a melody and you want to harmonize it with chords on the guitar. So let's just dig into the four steps that I want you to start following today in order to ensure that your strumming always sounds like a professional player. So step number one is quite simple, and part of it we have covered in a previous lesson where I spoke about how to hold your pick and how to pick against the strings. And here I want you to focus on one particular thing about picking, which is how are you going to grip the pick. So in order for you to strum effortlessly and ensure that the pick stays in your fingers all the time in one position, you need to ensure that your grip is strong on the pick. So it is not recommended to have a grip like this, which is going to be very flappy and which will make the pick brush against the strings a lot, and the friction will make the pick move inside your fingers. So you might have observed some guitar players when they try to strum very hard, the pick suddenly falls out of their hand. That's happening because of the friction from the string. So in order to avoid that, ensure that you have a tight grip on the pick. So step number two is slightly harder considering what we just covered in step number one, which was the grip on the pick, which needs to be hard. Whereas in step number two, you need to ensure that your wrist is nice and loose. So you want something which is like spaghetti wrist. You want the wrist to be free flowing and not tensed up like this. So I know it becomes particularly difficult if you want to grip the pick hard and then if you want to keep your wrist loose. So what I suggest you do is, you don't need the guitar for this. Take your pick, grip it properly, keep the pick gripped nicely with a tight grip, and then you just practice this motion. So do not do it on the guitar, just practice this away from the guitar whenever you have time. So try and simulate the real-time playing situation where your pick is going to be tight in your hands, at the same time your wrist is going to be loose. Which brings us to step number three, which is extremely important. How is your accuracy when you do your downstrokes and upstrokes? Now, what do I mean by accuracy? When you play chords on guitar, not always you will be needing to play all six strings. For example, there are chords which are played based off six strings, whereas there are other chords which will only require five strings to be played, some others which will only require four strings to be played. So in those cases, you have to ensure that every time you make a downstroke, it is as accurate as possible. So if you're playing a chord that is based off five strings, you have to ensure that you hit only those five strings. Now, one thing that I don't want you to do is to become overconscious about playing it perfectly and making your strumming hands suffer, because that is going to make your expressional ability reduce on the instrument, and that will not be good for your playing. So in your initial days, you should only focus on hitting the strings properly and expressing while you're strumming, rather than thinking about how many strings are you hitting. And one good way of doing that is, as you develop your skills on chord playing as well as strumming, I would highly suggest you learn the muting technique to keep the strings which you're not playing quieter. So that way, even if you end up hitting some of the strings which are not supposed to be hit, still they don't ring out and your playing does not suffer and you can express freely on the instrument. So that's about the downstroke. But most important thing when you strum is your upstroke. So when it comes to upstroke, you have to be absolutely carefree about it. And when I say carefree, I really mean it. What do I mean by being carefree? So like we talked about the downstroke, you have to be accurate. If you're playing five string chords, then you're hitting all five strings. If it is four string chords, you're hitting all four strings. Whereas when you do your upstroke, you do not have to hit all the strings on your way back up. Okay. So in fact, that sounds choppy and sounds not so fluent. Instead, what you do is, while doing your upstrokes, don't think about how many strings you're hitting. So on your way back, even if you just get one or two strings, that's absolutely fine. Watch how my hand moves when I'm doing an upstroke. I'll do it very slow. So I am not hitting all six strings on the way back up, like I did when I did the downstroke. This is what you also have to follow. So on the way back up, if you get one or two strings, that's fine. If you don't get anything, that is also fine. You can just be moving your hand upwards and miss some upstrokes. That's fine. It will sound good. Trust me. If you happen to do this painting kind of motion where you're getting all the strings, it might not sound that great. Listen to this. As opposed to this. So remember step number three, your downstroke can be accurate, but your upstroke has to be carefree. And that brings me to step number four, which is probably the most important one, and which is the one that most people get wrong all the time, and which is hesitating while strumming. So you have to get rid of your hesitations, be absolutely carefree about how your hand is moving. If you get this one step right, forget about everything else. You are going to sound professional every time you strum the guitar. So what do I mean by hesitation? Generally, what happens with beginners is they try to follow these wrong advices where they try to learn some patterns to strum with. Down, down, up, and all that stuff that you see written on top of songs by people when they put out chord charts. And then most guitar teachers also teach this way, where they try to teach students patterns, which really hampers their ability to express on the instrument, because the strumming hand suffers now, because you're always thinking in your mind, is my next stroke or an upstroke or a downstroke? How should I do it? That's called hesitation. You have to get rid of that mindset, come out of that, and be fluent and free thinking with your strumming, and that's where you will be able to express properly on the instrument whatever you're trying to play. And now comes the biggest secret to great strumming. So write this down, put it on your wall, put it in your practice area, look at it all the time, because I want you to follow this without any kind of doubts in your mind. And that thing is, you have to keep your hand going all the time. You cannot stop your strumming hand from moving, whether you're hitting the string or not. I want you to imagine that your hand is like a wiper on your car. So once you turn it on, its job is to go from one place to the other and continuously swing like a pendulum. It does not have to wait for the next raindrop to fall on your windshield so that it can make its next move. So that's how your hand is going to be. Once you start strumming, the hand never stops. Strumming hand does this continuous up and down movement whether or not it is playing the strings. Let's check out this clip of me playing the same rhythm and same chord progressions in two different ways. Close your eyes and just listen to how it sounds when I do it both the times. Thank you. Now, as you heard it, the first time everything sounds smooth and fluent. Whereas the second time, even though I'm playing the same thing, it sounds a bit choppy and robotic. I'm not sure whether you were able to recognize that, but any professional guitar player would be able to instantly recognize, even without watching the hands, that something is wrong with the way the guitar is being played. I've also seen many intermediate guitarists having strumming issues even years into their playing just because of this one reason. So my final and most important advice to all you people is, if you're a beginner guitarist, start following these four steps and ensure that you get your strumming right from day one itself. If you're an intermediate guitarist who feels stuck right now with your strumming skills, you can still fix it by following these methods. It will just take a little more time to unlearn all the old habits that you have. And the biggest takeaway for you from this lesson is, do not listen to people who say that you have to learn a certain type of strum pattern to play a particular song. Don't do that. Do not waste your time trying to learn strumming patterns. Instead, develop your rhythm guitar skills and internalize the rhythm, internalize strumming. That's where you're going to be doing it fluently on the instrument, and you'll be able to express freely when you play your rhythm guitar. Now let's talk about how to practice strumming. Now, strumming is an activity in your initial days that is going to create a lot of noise, especially if you're playing an acoustic guitar. And if you're living with other people, if you have neighbors around, they are not going to be happy. But does that mean you cannot practice strumming? Absolutely not. What you do instead is, you mute your strings with the fretting hand. So just lightly touch the strings and continue practicing your strumming skills. Tip number two, practice strumming anywhere, even when you don't have the guitar. This is one activity that you can practice anytime, anywhere. All you need is a pick. And if you are somebody who is looking forward to strumming with your fingers or hands, you don't need the pick also. What you have to do is, you have to imagine that you have the guitar with you, and you have to constantly follow this down-up movement wherever you are, and then create some rhythmic ideas in your mind and try to replicate that with your hand. That's how you develop your playing faster. So there you have it, my four-step method to perfect strumming. Whether you are a beginner player who is just getting started, or if you are an intermediate player, if you love what you learn, smash that like button, subscribe to the channel and turn on your notifications so that you can know whenever I upload the next lesson. Let me know your views, queries or issues that you're facing with your guitar playing through the comment section below, or if you want me to cover any topic of your choice in future lessons. Share this video with everyone who wants to learn so that you can do your bit to spread the learning. For many such learning resources, head over to learnguitaronline.in, where I have many articles that will keep you on track with your guitar playing. This is Dhanesh again from learnguitaronline.in, and I'll see you at your next lesson. I remember when I was a beginner guitarist, I used to be fascinated watching my favorite guitar players strumming effortlessly. And then I would observe a stark difference in the way beginners or amateur guitarists do it. It just didn't sound or feel right. So I used to wonder, is there a correct way? Is there a proper step-by-step method that we can follow in order to ensure that our strumming sounds like a professional player? Today I'm going to teach you four easy steps which you can start incorporating right now in order to ensure that every time you strum on the guitar, you sound like a pro. What's up everybody, welcome back. This is Dhanesh from learnguitaronline.in, and today we are going to be talking about one of my personal favorite topics, which is strumming. Now before we take a deeper look at how to fix your strumming and make it sound professional, let's first understand what is strumming. In this lesson series, Guitar Made Fun and Easy for Beginners, we have earlier spoken about fretting as well as picking. And when I was referring to picking, I was mostly talking about playing individual notes on single strings, something like this. To make it short and simple, strumming is the activity of playing multiple guitar strings together, especially when you're playing chords, so that you can create harmonized guitar lines which can support mostly vocal melodies. So you would mostly use strumming in order to play songs on the guitar while you're singing or you're supporting somebody else who is doing the singing. It could also be used in cases where some other instrument is playing a melody and you want to harmonize it with chords on the guitar. So let's just dig into the four steps that I want you to start following today in order to ensure that your strumming always sounds like a professional player. So step number one is quite simple, and part of it we have covered in a previous lesson where I spoke about how to hold your pick and how to pick against the strings. And here I want you to focus on one particular thing about picking, which is how are you going to grip the pick. So in order for you to strum effortlessly and ensure that the pick stays in your fingers all the time in one position, you need to ensure that your grip is strong on the pick. So it is not recommended to have a grip like this, which is going to be very flappy and which will make the pick brush against the strings a lot, and the friction will make the pick move inside your fingers. So you might have observed some guitar players when they try to strum very hard, the pick suddenly falls out of their hand. That's happening because of the friction from the string. So in order to avoid that, ensure that you have a tight grip on the pick. So step number two is slightly harder considering what we just covered in step number one, which was the grip on the pick, which needs to be hard. Whereas in step number two, you need to ensure that your wrist is nice and loose. So you want something which is like spaghetti wrist. You want the wrist to be free flowing and not tensed up like this. So I know it becomes particularly difficult if you want to grip the pick hard and then if you want to keep your wrist loose. So what I suggest you do is, you don't need the guitar for this. Take your pick, grip it properly, keep the pick gripped nicely with a tight grip, and then you just practice this motion. So do not do it on the guitar, just practice this away from the guitar whenever you have time. So try and simulate the real-time playing situation where your pick is going to be tight in your hands, at the same time your wrist is going to be loose. Which brings us to step number three, which is extremely important. How is your accuracy when you do your downstrokes and upstrokes? Now, what do I mean by accuracy? When you play chords on guitar, not always you will be needing to play all six strings. For example, there are chords which are played based off six strings, whereas there are other chords which will only require five strings to be played, some others which will only require four strings to be played. So in those cases, you have to ensure that every time you make a downstroke, it is as accurate as possible. So if you're playing a chord that is based off five strings, you have to ensure that you hit only those five strings. Now, one thing that I don't want you to do is to become overconscious about playing it perfectly and making your strumming hands suffer, because that is going to make your expressional ability reduce on the instrument, and that will not be good for your playing. So in your initial days, you should only focus on hitting the strings properly and expressing while you're strumming rather than thinking about how many strings are you hitting. And one good way of doing that is, as you develop your skills on chord playing as well as strumming, I would highly suggest you learn the muting technique to keep the strings which you're not playing quieter. So that way, even if you end up hitting some of the strings which are not supposed to be hit, still they don't ring out and your playing does not suffer and you can express freely on the instrument. So that's about the downstroke. But most important thing when you strum is your upstroke. So when it comes to upstroke, you have to be absolutely carefree about it. And when I say carefree, I really mean it. What do I mean by being carefree? So like we talked about the downstroke, you have to be accurate. If you're playing five string chords, then you're hitting all five strings. If it is four string chords, you're hitting all four strings. Whereas when you do your upstroke, you do not have to hit all the strings on your way back up. Okay, so in fact that sounds choppy and sounds not so fluent. Instead, what you do is while doing your upstrokes, don't think about how many strings you're hitting. So on your way back, even if you just get one or two strings, that's absolutely fine. Watch how my hand moves when I'm doing an upstroke. I'll do it very slow. So I am not hitting all six strings on the way back up like I did when I did the downstroke. This is what you also have to follow. So on the way back up, if you get one or two strings, that's fine. If you don't get anything, that is also fine. You can just be moving your hand upwards and miss some upstrokes. That's fine. It will sound good. Trust me. If you happen to do this painting kind of motion where you're getting all the strings, it might not sound that great. Listen to this. As opposed to this. So remember step number three, your downstroke can be accurate, but your upstroke has to be carefree. And that brings me to step number four, which is probably the most important one and which is the one that most people get wrong all the time, and which is hesitating while strumming. So you have to get rid of your hesitations, be absolutely carefree about how your hand is moving. If you get this one step right, forget about everything else. You are going to sound professional every time you strum the guitar. So what do I mean by hesitation? Generally, what happens with beginners is they try to follow these wrong advices where they try to learn some patterns to strum with. Down, down, up, and all that stuff that you see written on top of songs by people when they put out chord charts. And then most guitar teachers also teach this way, where they try to teach students patterns, which really hampers their ability to express on the instrument because the strumming hand suffers. Now, because you're always thinking in your mind, is my next stroke or an upstroke or a downstroke? How should I do it? That's called hesitation. You have to get rid of that mindset, come out of that, and be fluent and free thinking with your strumming, and that's where you will be able to express properly on the instrument whatever you're trying to play. And now comes the biggest secret to great strumming. So write this down, put it on your wall, put it in your practice area, look at it all the time, because I want you to follow this without any kind of doubts in your mind. And that thing is, you have to keep your hand going all the time. You cannot stop your strumming hand from moving whether you're hitting the string or not. I want you to imagine that your hand is like a wiper on your car. So once you turn it on, its job is to go from one place to the other and continuously swing like a pendulum. It does not have to wait for the next raindrop to fall on your windshield so that it can make its next move. So that's how your hand is going to be. Once you start strumming, the hand never stops. Strumming hand does this continuous up and down movement whether or not it is playing the strings. Let's check out this clip of me playing the same rhythm and same chord progressions in two different ways. Close your eyes and just listen to how it sounds when I do it both the times. Now, as you heard it, the first time everything sounds smooth and fluent. Whereas the second time, even though I'm playing the same thing, it sounds a bit choppy and robotic. I'm not sure whether you were able to recognize that, but any professional guitar player would be able to instantly recognize, even without watching the hands, that something is wrong with the way the guitar is being played. I've also seen many intermediate guitarists having strumming issues even years into their playing just because of this one reason. So my final and most important advice to all you people is, if you're a beginner guitarist, start following these four steps and ensure that you get your strumming right from day one itself. If you're an intermediate guitarist who feels stuck right now with your strumming skills, you can still fix it by following these methods. It will just take a little more time to unlearn all the old habits that you have. And the biggest takeaway for you from this lesson is, do not listen to people who say that you have to learn a certain type of strum pattern to play a particular song. Don't do that. Do not waste your time trying to learn strumming patterns. Instead, develop your rhythm guitar skills and internalize the rhythm, internalize strumming. That's where you're going to be doing it fluently on the instrument, and you'll be able to express freely when you play your rhythm guitar. Now let's talk about how to practice strumming. Now, strumming is an activity in your initial days that is going to create a lot of noise, especially if you're playing an acoustic guitar. And if you're living with other people, if you have neighbors around, they are not going to be happy. But does that mean you cannot practice strumming? Absolutely not. What you do instead is, you mute your strings with the fretting hand. So just lightly touch the strings and continue practicing your strumming skills. Tip number two, practice strumming anywhere, even when you don't have the guitar. This is one activity that you can practice anytime, anywhere. All you need is a pick. And if you are somebody who is looking forward to strumming with your fingers or hands, you don't need the pick also. What you have to do is, you have to imagine that you have the guitar with you, and you have to constantly follow this down-up movement wherever you are, and then create some rhythmic ideas in your mind and try to replicate that with your hand. That's how you develop your playing faster. So there you have it, my four-step method to perfect strumming. Whether you are a beginner player who is just getting started, or if you are an intermediate player, if you love what you learn, smash that like button, subscribe to the channel and turn on your notifications so that you can know whenever I upload the next lesson. Let me know your views, queries or issues that you're facing with your guitar playing through the comment section below, or if you want me to cover any topic of your choice in future lessons. Share this video with everyone who wants to learn so that you can do your bit to spread the learning. For many such learning resources, head over to learnguitaronline.in, where I have many articles that will keep you on track with your guitar playing. This is Dhanesh again from learnguitaronline.in, and I'll see you at your next lesson. I remember when I was a beginner guitarist, I used to be fascinated watching my favorite guitar players strumming effortlessly. And then I would observe a stark difference in the way beginners or amateur guitarists do it. It just didn't sound or feel right. So I used to wonder, is there a correct way? Is there a proper step-by-step method that we can follow in order to ensure that our strumming sounds like a professional player? Today I'm going to teach you four easy steps which you can start incorporating right now in order to ensure that every time you strum on the guitar, you sound like a pro. What's up everybody, welcome back. This is Dhanesh from learnguitaronline.in, and today we are going to be talking about one of my personal favorite topics, which is strumming. Now before we take a deeper look at how to fix your strumming and make it sound professional, let's first understand what is strumming. In this lesson series, Guitar Made Fun and Easy for Beginners, we have earlier spoken about fretting as well as picking. And when I was referring to picking, I was mostly talking about playing individual notes on single strings, something like this. To make it short and simple, strumming is the activity of playing multiple guitar strings together, especially when you're playing chords, so that you can create harmonized guitar lines which can support mostly vocal melodies. So you would mostly use strumming in order to play songs on the guitar while you're singing or you're supporting somebody else who is doing the singing. It could also be used in cases where some other instrument is playing a melody and you want to harmonize it with chords on the guitar. So let's just dig into the four steps that I want you to start following today in order to ensure that your strumming always sounds like a professional player. So step number one is quite simple, and part of it we have covered in a previous lesson where I spoke about how to hold your pick and how to pick against the strings. And here I want you to focus on one particular thing about picking, which is how are you going to grip the pick. So in order for you to strum effortlessly and ensure that the pick stays in your fingers all the time in one position, you need to ensure that your grip is strong on the pick. So it is not recommended to have a grip like this, which is going to be very flappy and which will make the pick brush against the strings a lot, and the friction will make the pick move inside your fingers. So you might have observed some guitar players when they try to strum very hard, the pick suddenly falls out of their hand. That's happening because of the friction from the string. So in order to avoid that, ensure that you have a tight grip on the pick. So step number two is slightly harder considering what we just covered in step number one, which was the grip on the pick, which needs to be hard. Whereas in step number two, you need to ensure that your wrist is nice and loose. So you want something which is like spaghetti wrist. You want the wrist to be free flowing and not tensed up like this. So I know it becomes particularly difficult if you want to grip the pick hard and then if you want to keep your wrist loose. So what I suggest you do is, you don't need the guitar for this. Take your pick, grip it properly, keep the pick gripped nicely with a tight grip, and then you just practice this motion. So do not do it on the guitar, just practice this away from the guitar whenever you have time. So try and simulate the real-time playing situation where your pick is going to be tight in your hands, at the same time your wrist is going to be loose. Which brings us to step number three, which is extremely important. How is your accuracy when you do your downstrokes and upstrokes? Now, what do I mean by accuracy? When you play chords on guitar, not always you will be needing to play all six strings. For example, there are chords which are played based off six strings, whereas there are other chords which will only require five strings to be played, some others which will only require four strings to be played. So in those cases, you have to ensure that every time you make a downstroke, it is as accurate as possible. So if you're playing a chord that is based off five strings, you have to ensure that you hit only those five strings. Now, one thing that I don't want you to do is to become overconscious about playing it perfectly and making your strumming hands suffer, because that is going to make your expressional ability reduce on the instrument, and that will not be good for your playing. So in your initial days, you should only focus on hitting the strings properly and expressing while you're strumming, rather than thinking about how many strings are you hitting. And one good way of doing that is, as you develop your skills on chord playing as well as strumming, I would highly suggest you learn the muting technique to keep the strings which you're not playing quieter. So that way, even if you end up hitting some of the strings which are not supposed to be hit, still they don't ring out and your playing does not suffer and you can express freely on the instrument. So that's about the downstroke. But most important thing when you strum is your upstroke. So when it comes to upstroke, you have to be absolutely carefree about it. And when I say carefree, I really mean it. What do I mean by being carefree? So like we talked about the downstroke, you have to be accurate. If you're playing five string chords, then you're hitting all five strings. If it is four string chords, you're hitting all four strings. Whereas when you do your upstroke, you do not have to hit all the strings on your way back up. Okay. So in fact, that sounds choppy and sounds not so fluent. Instead, what you do is, while doing your upstrokes, don't think about how many strings you're hitting. So on your way back, even if you just get one or two strings, that's absolutely fine. Watch how my hand moves when I'm doing an upstroke. I'll do it very slow. So I am not hitting all six strings on the way back up, like I did when I did the downstroke. This is what you also have to follow. So on the way back up, if you get one or two strings, that's fine. If you don't get anything, that is also fine. You can just be moving your hand upwards and miss some upstrokes. That's fine. It will sound good. Trust me. If you happen to do this painting kind of motion where you're getting all the strings, it might not sound that great. Listen to this. As opposed to this. So remember step number 3, your downstroke can be accurate, but your upstroke has to be carefree. And that brings me to step number 4, which is probably the most important one and which is the one that most people get wrong all the time, and which is hesitating while strumming. So you have to get rid of your hesitations, be absolutely carefree about how your hand is moving. If you get this one step right, forget about everything else. You are going to sound professional every time you strum the guitar. So what do I mean by hesitation? Generally, what happens with beginners is they try to follow these wrong advices where they try to learn some patterns to strum with. Down, down, up, and all that stuff that you see written on top of songs by people when they put out chord charts. And then most guitar teachers also teach this way, where they try to teach students patterns, which really hampers their ability to express on the instrument because the strumming hand suffers. Now, because you're always thinking in your mind, is my next stroke or an upstroke or a downstroke? How should I do it? That's called hesitation. You have to get rid of that mindset, come out of that, and be fluent and free thinking with your strumming, and that's where you will be able to express properly on the instrument whatever you're trying to play. And now comes the biggest secret to great strumming. So write this down, put it on your wall, put it in your practice area, look at it all the time, because I want you to follow this without any kind of doubts in your mind. And that thing is, you have to keep your hand going all the time. You cannot stop your strumming hand from moving whether you're hitting the string or not. I want you to imagine that your hand is like a wiper on your car. So once you turn it on, its job is to go from one place to the other and continuously swing like a pendulum. It does not have to wait for the next raindrop to fall on your windshield so that it can make its next move. So that's how your hand is going to be. Once you start strumming, the hand never stops. Strumming hand does this continuous up and down movement whether or not it is playing the strings. Let's check out this clip of me playing the same rhythm and same chord progressions in two different ways. Close your eyes and just listen to how it sounds when I do it both the times. Now, as you heard it, the first time everything sounds smooth and fluent. Whereas the second time, even though I'm playing the same thing, it sounds a bit choppy and robotic. I'm not sure whether you were able to recognize that, but any professional guitar player would be able to instantly recognize, even without watching the hands, that something is wrong with the way the guitar is being played. I've also seen many intermediate guitarists having strumming issues even years into their playing just because of this one reason. So my final and most important advice to all you people is, if you're a beginner guitarist, start following these 4 steps and ensure that you get your strumming right from day one itself. If you're an intermediate guitarist who feels stuck right now with your strumming skills, you can still fix it by following these methods. It will just take a little more time to unlearn all the old habits that you have. And the biggest takeaway for you from this lesson is, do not listen to people who say that you have to learn a certain type of strum pattern to play a particular song. Don't do that. Do not waste your time trying to learn strumming patterns. Instead, develop your rhythm guitar skills and internalize the rhythm, internalize strumming. That's where you're going to be doing it fluently on the instrument, and you will be able to express freely when you play your rhythm guitar. Now let's talk about how to practice strumming. Now, strumming is an activity in your initial days that is going to create a lot of noise, especially if you're playing an acoustic guitar. And if you're living with other people, if you have neighbors around, they are not going to be happy. But does that mean you cannot practice strumming? Absolutely not. What you do instead is you mute your strings with the fretting hand. So just lightly touch the strings and continue practicing your strumming skills. Tip number two, practice strumming anywhere, even when you don't have the guitar. This is one activity that you can practice anytime, anywhere. All you need is a pick. And if you are somebody who is looking forward to strumming with your fingers or hands, you don't need the pick also. What you have to do is you have to imagine that you have the guitar with you, and you have to constantly follow this down-up movement wherever you are, and then create some rhythmic ideas in your mind and try to replicate that with your hand. That's how you develop your playing faster. So there you have it, my 4-step method to perfect strumming. Whether you are a beginner player who is just getting started, or if you are an intermediate player, if you love what you learn, smash that like button, subscribe to the channel and turn on your notifications so that you can know whenever I upload the next lesson. Let me know your views, queries or issues that you're facing with your guitar playing through the comment section below, or if you want me to cover any topic of your choice in future lessons. Share this video with everyone who wants to learn so that you can do your bit to spread the learning. For many such learning resources, head over to learnguitaronline.in, where I have many articles that will keep you on track with your guitar playing. This is Dhanesh again from learnguitaronline.in, and I'll see you at your next lesson. I remember when I was a beginner guitarist, I used to be fascinated watching my favorite guitar players strumming effortlessly. And then I would observe a stark difference in the way beginners or amateur guitarists do it. It just didn't sound or feel right. So I used to wonder, is there a correct way? Is there a proper step-by-step method that we can follow in order to ensure that our strumming sounds like a professional player? Today I'm going to teach you 4 easy steps which you can start incorporating right now in order to ensure that every time you strum on the guitar, you sound like a pro. What's up everybody, welcome back. This is Dhanesh from learnguitaronline.in, and today we are going to be talking about one of my personal favorite topics, which is strumming. Now before we take a deeper look at how to fix your strumming and make it sound professional, let's first understand what is strumming. In this lesson series, Guitar Made Fun and Easy for Beginners, we have earlier spoken about fretting as well as picking. And when I was referring to picking, I was mostly talking about playing individual notes on single strings, something like this. To make it short and simple, strumming is the activity of playing multiple guitar strings together, especially when you're playing chords, so that you can create harmonized guitar lines which can support mostly vocal melodies. So you would mostly use strumming in order to play songs on the guitar while you're singing, or you're supporting somebody else who is doing the singing. It could also be used in cases where some other instrument is playing a melody and you want to harmonize it with chords on the guitar. So let's just dig into the 4 steps that I want you to start following today in order to ensure that your strumming always sounds like a professional player. So step number 1 is quite simple, and part of it we have covered in a previous lesson where I spoke about how to hold your pick and how to pick against the strings. And here I want you to focus on one particular thing about picking, which is how are you going to grip the pick. So in order for you to strum effortlessly and ensure that the pick stays in your fingers all the time in one position, you need to ensure that your grip is strong on the pick. So it is not recommended to have a grip like this, which is going to be very flappy and which will make the pick brush against the strings a lot, and the friction will make the pick move inside your fingers. So you might have observed some guitar players, when they try to strum very hard, the pick suddenly falls out of their hand. That's happening because of the friction from the string. So in order to avoid that, ensure that you have a tight grip on the pick. So step number two is slightly harder considering what we just covered in step number one, which was the grip on the pick, which needs to be hard. Whereas in step number two, you need to ensure that your wrist is nice and loose. So you want something which is like spaghetti wrist. You want the wrist to be free flowing and not tensed up like this. So I know it becomes particularly difficult if you want to grip the pick hard and then if you want to keep your wrist loose. So what I suggest you do is, you don't need the guitar for this. Take your pick, grip it properly, keep the pick gripped nicely with a tight grip, and then you just practice this motion. So do not do it on the guitar, just practice this away from the guitar whenever you have time. So try and simulate the real-time playing situation where your pick is going to be tight in your hands, at the same time your wrist is going to be loose. Which brings us to step number three, which is extremely important. How is your accuracy when you do your downstrokes and upstrokes? Now, what do I mean by accuracy? When you play chords on guitar, not always you will be needing to play all six strings. For example, there are chords which are played based off six strings, whereas there are other chords which will only require five strings to be played, some others which will only require four strings to be played. So in those cases, you have to ensure that every time you make a downstroke, it is as accurate as possible. So if you're playing a chord that is based off five strings, you have to ensure that you hit only those five strings. Now, one thing that I don't want you to do is to become overconscious about playing it perfectly and making your strumming hands suffer, because that is going to make your expressional ability reduce on the instrument, and that will not be good for your playing. So in your initial days, you should only focus on hitting the strings properly and expressing while you're strumming, rather than thinking about how many strings are you hitting. And one good way of doing that is, as you develop your skills on chord playing as well as strumming, I would highly suggest you learn the muting technique to keep the strings which you're not playing quieter. So that way, even if you end up hitting some of the strings which are not supposed to be hit, still they don't ring out and your playing does not suffer and you can express freely on the instrument. So that's about the downstroke. But most important thing when you strum is your upstroke. So when it comes to upstroke, you have to be absolutely carefree about it. And when I say carefree, I really mean it. What do I mean by being carefree? So like we talked about the downstroke, you have to be accurate. If you're playing five string chords, then you're hitting all five strings. If it is four string chords, you're hitting all four strings. Whereas when you do your upstroke, you do not have to hit all the strings on your way back up. Okay. So in fact, that sounds choppy and sounds not so fluent. Instead, what you do is, while doing your upstrokes, don't think about how many strings you're hitting. So on your way back, even if you just get one or two strings, that's absolutely fine. Watch how my hand moves when I'm doing an upstroke. I'll do it very slow. So I am not hitting all six strings on the way back up, like I did when I did the downstroke. This is what you also have to follow. So on the way back up, if you get one or two strings, that's fine. If you don't get anything, that is also fine. You can just be moving your hand upwards and miss some upstrokes. That's fine. It will sound good. Trust me. If you happen to do this painting kind of motion where you're getting all the strings, it might not sound that great. Listen to this. As opposed to this. So remember step number three, your downstroke can be accurate, but your upstroke has to be carefree. And that brings me to step number four, which is probably the most important one, and which is the one that most people get wrong all the time and which is hesitating while strumming. So you have to get rid of your hesitations, be absolutely carefree about how your hand is moving. If you get this one step right, forget about everything else, you are going to sound professional every time you strum the guitar. So what do I mean by hesitation? Generally, what happens with beginners is they try to follow these wrong advices where they try to learn some patterns to strum with. Down, down, up, and all that stuff that you see written on top of songs by people when they put out chord charts. And then most guitar teachers also teach this way, where they try to teach students patterns, which really hampers their ability to express on the instrument because the strumming hand suffers. Now, because you're always thinking in your mind, is my next stroke or an upstroke or a downstroke? How should I do it? That's called hesitation. You have to get rid of that mindset, come out of that, and be fluent and free thinking with your strumming, and that's where you will be able to express properly on the instrument whatever you're trying to play. And now comes the biggest secret to great strumming. So write this down, put it on your wall, put it in your practice area, look at it all the time, because I want you to follow this without any kind of doubts in your mind. And that thing is, you have to keep your hand going all the time. You cannot stop your strumming hand from moving whether you're hitting the string or not. I want you to imagine that your hand is like a wiper on your car. So once you turn it on, its job is to go from one place to the other and continuously swing like a pendulum. It does not have to wait for the next raindrop to fall on your windshield so that it can make its next move. So that's how your hand is going to be. Once you start strumming, the hand never stops. Strumming hand does this continuous up and down movement whether or not it is playing the strings. Let's check out this clip of me playing the same rhythm and same chord progressions in two different ways. Close your eyes and just listen to how it sounds when I do it both the times. Now, as you heard it, the first time everything sounds smooth and fluent. Whereas the second time, even though I'm playing the same thing, it sounds a bit choppy and robotic. I'm not sure whether you were able to recognize that, but any professional guitar player would be able to instantly recognize, even without watching the hands, that something is wrong with the way the guitar is being played. I've also seen many intermediate guitarists having strumming issues even years into their playing just because of this one reason. So my final and most important advice to all you people is, if you're a beginner guitarist, start following these four steps and ensure that you get your strumming right from day one itself. If you're an intermediate guitarist who feels stuck right now with your strumming skills, you can still fix it by following these methods. It will just take a little more time to unlearn all the old habits that you have. And the biggest takeaway for you from this lesson is, do not listen to people who say that you have to learn a certain type of strum pattern to play a particular song. Don't do that. Do not waste your time trying to learn strumming patterns. Instead, develop your rhythm guitar skills and internalize the rhythm, internalize strumming. That's where you're going to be doing it fluently on the instrument, and you'll be able to express freely when you play your rhythm guitar. Now let's talk about how to practice strumming. Now, strumming is an activity in your initial days that is going to create a lot of noise, especially if you're playing an acoustic guitar. And if you're living with other people, if you have neighbors around, they are not going to be happy. But does that mean you cannot practice strumming? Absolutely not. What you do instead is, you mute your strings with the fretting hand. So just lightly touch the strings and continue practicing your strumming skills. Tip number two, Practice strumming anywhere, even when you don't have the guitar. This is one activity that you can practice anytime, anywhere. All you need is a pick. And if you are somebody who is looking forward to strumming with your fingers or hands, you don't need the pick also. What you have to do is you have to imagine that you have the guitar with you and you have to constantly follow this down-up movement wherever you are, and then create some rhythmic ideas in your mind and try to replicate that with your hand. That's how you develop your playing faster. So there you have it, my 4-step method to perfect strumming. Whether you are a beginner player who is just getting started, or if you are an intermediate player, if you love what you learn, smash that like button, subscribe to the channel and turn on your notifications so that you can know whenever I upload the next lesson. Let me know your views, queries or issues that you're facing with your guitar playing through the comment section below, or if you want me to cover any topic of your choice in future lessons. Share this video with everyone who wants to learn so that you can do your bit to spread the learning. For many such learning resources, head over to learnguitaronline.in, where I have many articles that will keep you on track with your guitar playing. This is Dhanesh again from learnguitaronline.in, and I'll see you at your next lesson. I remember when I was a beginner guitarist, I used to be fascinated watching my favorite guitar players strumming effortlessly. And then I would observe a stark difference in the way beginners or amateur guitarists do it. It just didn't sound or feel right. So I used to wonder, is there a correct way? Is there a proper step-by-step method that we can follow in order to ensure that our strumming sounds like a professional player? Today I'm going to teach you 4 easy steps which you can start incorporating right now in order to ensure that every time you strum on the guitar, you sound like a pro. What's up everybody? Welcome back. This is Dhanesh from learnguitaronline.in, and today we are going to be talking about one of my personal favorite topics, which is strumming. Now, before we take a deeper look at how to fix your strumming and make it sound professional, let's first understand what is strumming. In this lesson series, Guitar Made Fun and Easy for Beginners, we have earlier spoken about fretting as well as picking. And when I was referring to picking, I was mostly talking about playing individual notes on single strings, something like this. To make it short and simple, strumming is the activity of playing multiple guitar strings together, especially when you're playing chords, so that you can create harmonized guitar lines which can support mostly vocal melodies. So you would mostly use strumming in order to play songs on the guitar while you're singing, or you're supporting somebody else who is doing the singing. It could also be used in cases where some other instrument is playing a melody and you want to harmonize it with chords on the guitar. So let's just dig into the 4 steps that I want you to start following today in order to ensure that your strumming always sounds like a professional player. So step number 1 is quite simple, and part of it we have covered in a previous lesson where I spoke about how to hold your pick and how to pick against the strings. And here I want you to focus on one particular thing about picking, which is how are you going to grip the pick. So in order for you to strum effortlessly and ensure that the pick stays in your fingers all the time in one position, you need to ensure that your grip is strong on the pick. So it is not recommended to have a grip like this, which is going to be very flappy and which will make the pick brush against the strings a lot, and the friction will make the pick move inside your fingers. So you might have observed some guitar players, when they try to strum very hard, the pick suddenly falls out of their hand. That's happening because of the friction from the string. So in order to avoid that, ensure that you have a tight grip on the pick. So step number 2 is slightly harder considering what we just covered in step number 1, which was the grip on the pick, which needs to be hard. Whereas in step number two, you need to ensure that your wrist is nice and loose. So you want something which is like spaghetti wrist. You want the wrist to be free flowing and not tensed up like this. So I know it becomes particularly difficult if you want to grip the pick hard and then if you want to keep your wrist loose. So what I suggest you do is, you don't need the guitar for this. Take your pick, grip it properly, keep the pick gripped nicely with a tight grip, and then you just practice this motion. So do not do it on the guitar, just practice this away from the guitar whenever you have time. So try and simulate the real-time playing situation where your pick is going to be tight in your hands, at the same time your wrist is going to be loose. Which brings us to step number three, which is extremely important. How is your accuracy when you do your downstrokes and upstrokes? Now, what do I mean by accuracy? When you play chords on guitar, not always you will be needing to play all six strings. For example, there are chords which are played based off six strings, whereas there are other chords which will only require five strings to be played, some others which will only require four strings to be played. So in those cases, you have to ensure that every time you make a downstroke, it is as accurate as possible. So if you're playing a chord that is based off five strings, you have to ensure that you hit only those five strings. Now, one thing that I don't want you to do is to become overconscious about playing it perfectly and making your strumming hands suffer, because that is going to make your expressional ability reduce on the instrument and that will not be good for your playing. So in your initial days, you should only focus on hitting the strings properly and expressing while you're strumming rather than thinking about how many strings are you hitting. And one good way of doing that is as you develop your skills on chord playing as well as strumming, I would highly suggest you learn the muting technique to keep the strings which you're not playing quieter. So that way, even if you end up hitting some of the strings which are not supposed to be hit, still they don't ring out and your playing does not suffer and you can express freely on the instrument. So that's about the downstroke. But most important thing when you strum is your upstroke. So when it comes to upstroke, you have to be absolutely carefree about it. And when I say carefree, I really mean it. What do I mean by being carefree? So like we talked about the downstroke, you have to be accurate. If you're playing five string chords, then you're hitting all five strings. If it is four string chords, you're hitting all four strings. Whereas when you do your upstroke, you do not have to hit all the strings on your way back up. Okay. So in fact, that sounds choppy and sounds not so fluent. Instead, what you do is while doing your upstrokes, don't think about how many strings you're hitting. So on your way back, even if you just get one or two strings, that's absolutely fine. Watch how my hand moves when I'm doing an upstroke. I'll do it very slow. So I am not hitting all six strings on the way back up like I did when I did the downstroke. This is what you also have to follow. So on the way back up, if you get one or two strings, that's fine. If you don't get anything, that is also fine. You can just be moving your hand upwards and miss some upstrokes. That's fine. It will sound good. Trust me. If you happen to do this painting kind of motion where you're getting all the strings, it might not sound that great. Listen to this. As opposed to this. So remember step number three, your downstroke can be accurate, but your upstroke has to be carefree. And that brings me to step number four, which is probably the most important one and which is the one that most people get wrong all the time, and which is hesitating while strumming. So you have to get rid of your hesitations, be absolutely carefree about how your hand is moving. If you get this one step right, forget about everything else. You are going to sound professional every time you strum the guitar. So what do I mean by hesitation? Generally, what happens with beginners is they try to follow these wrong advices where they try to learn some patterns to strum with. Down, down, up, and all that stuff that you see written on top of songs by people when they put out chord charts. And then most guitar teachers also teach this way, where they try to teach students patterns, which really hampers their ability to express on the instrument because the strumming hand suffers now, because you're always thinking in your mind, is my next stroke or an upstroke or a downstroke? How should I do it? That's called hesitation. You have to get rid of that mindset, come out of that, and be fluent and free thinking with your strumming, and that's where you will be able to express properly on the instrument whatever you're trying to play. And now comes the biggest secret to great strumming. So write this down, put it on your wall, put it in your practice area, look at it all the time, because I want you to follow this without any kind of doubts in your mind. And that thing is, you have to keep your hand going all the time. You cannot stop your strumming hand from moving whether you're hitting the string or not. I want you to imagine that your hand is like a wiper on your car. So once you turn it on, its job is to go from one place to the other and continuously swing like a pendulum. It does not have to wait for the next raindrop to fall on your windshield so that it can make its next move. So that's how your hand is going to be. Once you start strumming, the hand never stops. Strumming hand does this continuous up and down movement whether or not it is playing the strings. Let's check out this clip of me playing the same rhythm and same chord progressions in two different ways. Close your eyes and just listen to how it sounds when I do it both the times. Now, as you heard it, the first time everything sounds smooth and fluent. Whereas the second time, even though I'm playing the same thing, it sounds a bit choppy and robotic. I'm not sure whether you were able to recognize that, but any professional guitar player would be able to instantly recognize, even without watching the hands, that something is wrong with the way the guitar is being played. I've also seen many intermediate guitarists having strumming issues even years into their playing just because of this one reason. So my final and most important advice to all you people is, if you're a beginner guitarist, start following these four steps and ensure that you get your strumming right from day one itself. If you're an intermediate guitarist who feels stuck right now with your strumming skills, you can still fix it by following these methods. It will just take a little more time to unlearn all the old habits that you have. And the biggest takeaway for you from this lesson is, do not listen to people who say that you have to learn a certain type of strum pattern to play a particular song. Don't do that. Do not waste your time trying to learn strumming patterns. Instead, develop your rhythm guitar skills and internalize the rhythm, internalize strumming. That's where you're going to be doing it fluently on the instrument, and you'll be able to express freely when you play your rhythm guitar. Now let's talk about how to practice strumming. Now, strumming is an activity in your initial days that is going to create a lot of noise, especially if you're playing an acoustic guitar. And if you're living with other people, if you have neighbors around, they are not going to be happy. But does that mean you cannot practice strumming? Absolutely not. What you do instead is, you mute your strings with the fretting hand. So just lightly touch the strings and continue practicing your strumming skills. Tip number two. Practice strumming anywhere, even when you don't have the guitar. This is one activity that you can practice anytime, anywhere. All you need is a pick. And if you are somebody who is looking forward to strumming with your fingers or hands, you don't need the pick also. What you have to do is, you have to imagine that you have the guitar with you, and you have to constantly follow this down-up movement wherever you are, and then create some rhythmic ideas in your mind and try to replicate that with your hand. That's how you develop your playing faster. So there you have it, my four-step method to perfect strumming, whether you are a beginner player who is just getting started, or if you are an intermediate player. If you love what you learn, smash that like button, subscribe to the channel and turn on your notifications so that you can know whenever I upload the next lesson. Let me know your views queries or issues that you're facing with your guitar playing through the comment section below, or if you want me to cover any topic of your choice in future lessons. Share this video with everyone who wants to learn so that you can do your bit to spread the learning. For many such learning resources, head over to learnguitaronline.in where I have many articles that will keep you on track with your guitar playing. This is Dhanesh again from learnguitaronline.in and I'll see you at your next lesson.